The Lions take aim at a title.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1991 NCAA Men's Gymnastics Championships. Hello, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel. Welcome to Rec Hall on the campus of Penn State University, where today we'll find out which of three teams, UCLA, Oklahoma, or the Nittany Lions of Penn State, will succeed Nebraska as champions in men's gymnastics. Working alongside me today, former All-American and member of that 1984 U.S. Olympic gold medal winning team, Peter Vidmar. And Peter, it is said that this competition is perhaps the closest in recent years. Why?
Well, I think it'll be the closest because every athlete out there on that floor is very healthy. This is a no-excuses NCAA championships. And for the first time in years, we're going to find out exactly who the best team really is.
The fact that everyone is healthy is good news for anyone watching, because on display here today will be some of the best gymnasts in the country.
Yeah, two great all-around performers from UCLA, Scott Keswick, Cheney Humphrey, and also Oklahoma has two really superstar athletes in Jared Hanks and Jeff Lutz. Penn State doesn't have a lot of superstars, but they have a lot of depth and talent in gymnasts like Adam Carton. If they can pull off this victory, though, they'll become the first Penn State team in many years to win the title. They'll give their coach his first victory in his whole 27-year career as an NCAA Division I coach.
Rules are as follows. Each team will put six gymnasts to work at each apparatus using the five best scores, and, of course, the highest cumulative score will win. These are the first three rotations, and then the teams will change up. And going to work right now is UCLA's Cheney Humphrey, the All-American, and he's about to perform his floor exercise, Peter.
And this is a very important routine for Cheney, because the gymnasts that have gone up before for UCLA have had some problems. They look kind of tired, actually. He mounts with a double layout, very difficult mount, but see that stumble forward. That tends to happen when athletes are tired. A lot of the UCLA gymnasts have done that so far. This is a required press to a handstand. For good gymnasts, it gives them a chance to rest, really, while they're upside down. Cheney is the Olympic Festival all-around champion from last year. Second pass is a full in back out, very difficult, but then a big hop. That's also going to cost him. UCLA really needs a good score from Cheney. As I said, the first few gymnasts have had some problems. The scores are low. They need some big ones right now. A required front tumbling pass, handspring pike front. And now he sets up for his dismount. Cheney doesn't fit the mold of the average gymnast. He's very big and bulky, a lot of strength, a lot of power. Dismounts with a round off back handspring, double back, great landing.
All-American Cheney Humphrey from UCLA. And a 9.3.
And a 9.3 really is not good enough. They need some much higher scores to pick up with the rest of the teams in this competition.
This is Oklahoma's Jared Hanks, Nissan Award winner, and that's about as high as you can go as a gymnast, isn't it?
It really is the Heisman Trophy of gymnastics. He's working across the horse, Jared doing some great flare work. This is a critical event for Oklahoma. This was a disaster for them at the regional qualifying competition. And so far, they've been off to a great start. Works right across the horse, scissor break. There's the required pendulum swing on pommel horse. Getting ready for his dismount. The stock layout right up to a handstand. This is a great set. This is the way it's been going for Oklahoma during the entire pommel horse competition.
So the senior from Lafayette, Louisiana, Jared Hanks, being welcomed by his teammates and registered a 9.725. Now here's Penn State's Mike Reichenbach.
Now, Penn State got into this team finals by a squeaker, beating Minnesota by just 0.1 of a point. They get a lot of help on the rings where they're super strong. Look at these two Olympic L crosses in a row by Mike. into a back roll to another iron cross. Just incredible. They're the best team in the country on the rings, and they need this to start off very strong. Press to a handstand. Giant to a handstand. And a front giant, now getting set for his dismount. There's a giant dislocate into a half in, half out, a full twisting double back, great landing. They're off to a super start as well.
Understandably well received by the fans here at Penn State University, Mike Reichenbach. With a 9-8-5 on the rings. And after the first rotation, Penn State gets off to a good start, followed by Oklahoma and UCLA.
CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Men's Gymnastics Championships is sponsored by Honda, maker of fine quality automobiles. Test drive a Honda at your local dealer today. DuPont, better things for better living. And by Carrier, ever since we invented air conditioning, we've been making it better inside. We're the inside guys.
Penn State now moves to the floor exercise, and this is senior Jamie Downer from Southampton, England. And Coach Carl Shire's made a habit of bringing Britishers over to compete for him.
He has, and there's his father, his first time really seeing his son compete in the last 5 years. Jimmy mounts with a round-off fake answering Arabian 1 3/4 dive roll. That's not a very difficult mount. He's a solid gymnast, peaking at the right time. There's a double full. He's peaking at the right time. He had a great performance in the preliminaries, a career best. Now, I have to be honest, so far this routine is not nearly as difficult, for example, as Cheney Humphrey. But the name of the game under pressure is that you have to be consistent. And Jamie's hitting his routine right now, right on target. That was a nice plunge press to a handstand. Round off pike straddle side flip. Once again, it's a very simple skill relative to many of the skills that we're seeing done today in gymnastics. Required balance move on one leg, a front scale, gives him a chance to rest, catch his breath, move into that final tumbling pass. And he finishes with a round off back handspring, layout double twist to a great landing.
The Nittany Lion crowd applauds, and so does Jamie's dad. Peter, you mentioned not a particularly difficult routine. How do the judges look at that? Would they prefer to see a tougher routine attempted?
I think they'd like to see a tougher routine, but if someone makes a mistake, as did Cheney in a very difficult one, they simply have to deduct.
Well, Jamie registers a 9.7. And moving over to the pommel horse, Cheney Humphrey, contemplating his task, Peter Vidmar has a closer look.
If you had to take a survey of all the gymnasts here and ask them, hey, what's the most difficult event in competition, many would say the pommel horse. There's three basic swings on the pommel horse. A pendulum swing back and forth with legs apart, it's called scissors. Circular swing with legs together, called double leg circles. And then, of course, the most exciting part of pommel horse, the flares. What makes this event difficult is the fact that you have to do many different intricate skills with those basic elements. Moving up and down the horse, doing certain skills on one pommel. And what also makes the pommel horse difficult is that you never have the opportunity to stop. If the athlete is off balance, he has to adjust instantaneously or he's on his back. He doesn't have the luxury of resting in a handstand like the gymnast does on the rings or on the parallel bars.
So UCLA's Cheney Humphrey, also on the team, younger brother Greg, who told us this little story about him and his older brother.
One time my brother was getting beat up by this one boy, I think it was in third grade, and I used to always pretend like I was Superman. I'd wear the Superman costume under my clothes. And so one day he actually did get in this fight, and I stripped off all my clothes, had my Superman costume underneath, and ran and beat up the guy for him.
Nice to have Superman coming to your rescue, isn't it?
No kidding. Then he starts off very strong, moving across the horse. This is a very important, oh, that's a big mistake. They need a good score from Cheney. This is not gonna help.
Greg offering encouragement. Cheney has been bothered with a sore shoulder.
He has. It really shouldn't bother him on pommel horse, though, because pommel horse does not take much out on your shoulders. I'll tell you, last year, this same thing happened to UCLA. They had problems on the pommel horse. They got off to a slow start, and they never recovered. They're in big trouble.
Let's go back and try to find out where Cheney went wrong.
Well, it seemed as if he was moving across the horse. Cheney was leaning forward too much and never quite recovered there. As I said earlier, if you're off balance, you got to make the adjustment right away.
So UCLA still staggering, an 8.7 for Cheney Humphrey. It's tough to come back in gymnastics, too, isn't it?
It really is, and they were hoping for a 9.7 from Cheney, so that hurt them quite a bit.
Here's Oklahoma's Jeff Lutz.
Jeff's gymnast looks quite deceiving. He's not real bulky like Cheney, yet he has all the power that a gymnast like Cheney Humphrey has. It was a great L cross to a pull-out, forward roll to another cross pull-out. That's called a hollow back press to a handstand. Front giant. Another front giant. Boy, this is a really solid routine. Getting ready for his dismount. A double layout with a perfect landing. Oklahoma is not letting up.
Well, he said UCLA is staggering. Oklahoma having no such problems and a lot of confidence being shown at the Oklahoma bench. Jeff Lutz, the senior from Fort Worth, Texas. A 9.875, and Oklahoma right behind Penn State after two rotations. Well, welcome back, everyone. Oklahoma now moves to the floor exercise, trailing Penn State. UCLA is running third after two rotations. And the Sooners now move to the floor exercise, and Marcus Jordan is the first man up for Oklahoma. How important is it for the first competitor to get off to a good start?
Well, momentum is a real key ingredient, and if the first guy goes up and does well, it sets the pace for the rest of the team. And that was a great Arabian double front. Look how high he got. Second tumbling pass, round off against spring, double tuck. He's right on target. This is really going to help. Floor exercise is a very comfortable event for Oklahoma. In fact, they say this is probably their best event in competition. There's a press to a handstand. So far, really no mistakes from Jordan right now. Here's another required front tumbling pass. A front flip into another front flip. Now, they're not tumbling on just a floor. They've got 4-inch coiled springs underneath that with about 3 inches of very resilient foam. Gymnast is still doing most of the work, but the equipment does help. Sets up for his dismount. Round off back handspring, double tuck. A great start for Oklahoma on floor.
Marcus Jordan, the sophomore from Tulsa, at 5'9". He's pretty big for a gymnast, isn't he?
He is big, but that bigness helps. Take a look at his second tumbling pass, a double tuck. He goes way up in the air. Lots of time to see the ground and land.
Oh, he talked about getting a team off to a good start. Marcus Jordan with a 9.675 on the floor exercise. And here's Adam Carton, and let's see if Penn State answers that challenge from the Sooners, who are breathing down their necks.
And once again, pommel horse is a difficult event under pressure. This is important for Penn State. Adam starts by working across the horse, swinging lengthwise, back to the other side. Little form break there. He's brushing against the horse just a little bit too much, but so far he hasn't had a major break. Good routine for Adam. Little brushes here and there, but he should get a decent score.
9.45 is the score for junior Adam Carton, and we move to the rings and UCLA Scott Keswick.
Scott's had a great year for UCLA. He was the Pac-10 Gymnast of the Year. He was actually the leading all-around qualifier going into the team finals. It's a back kip to a cross, pull out. A nice hollow back press to a handstand. There's a back giant. Take a look at that. That's an inverted cross. Just like the Iron Cross, but upside down. Back up rise to a handstand is a very steady routine. Double front within the rings. Scott does a very hard dismount. A double twisting, double back flip, little hop on the landing, but that's as hard a routine as we've seen so far today.
Peter, you mentioned the inverted cross. Why is it so tough?
Well, it takes a tremendous amount of strain on the shoulders and even on the elbows as he locks his arm in that position right there. Once again, the rings move. Those aren't stationary, so maintaining the balance is also very difficult. Now, his dismount also helps to set him apart from many other gymnasts. It's two twists in two flips. Very tough.
So the Bruins in third place trying to battle back, and Scott Keswick registers a 9.85 on the rings. And back to the floor exercise now, and Oklahoma's Jared Hanks, who earlier this year broke the all-around record of former Oklahoma Sooner and former Olympic gold medalist Bart Conner.
I didn't think about it until after the meet was totally over. No, I was just competing, having a really good meet, and after Pommel Horse was over, I said, well, did I break it? And, you know, I had done it and felt really good, you know, because as a young gymnast a long time ago, back in 1983, I was always looking up to Bart Conner, and now here I am following in his footsteps, and it feels pretty good.
Following in those footsteps very well, Bart set some pretty good standards at OU, didn't he?
He sure did. He was a great gymnast.
Jared feels good about this event, doesn't he?
He does, and it shows here. That was a piked, one-and-a-half twisting, one-and-three-quarter dive roll. And usually he comes back again with the same skill, but in the tuck position, and there it is. And watch this. This is a real crowd pleaser. A little break dancing right into a flange. Puts his legs together and then presses right up to a handstand. A lot of power. Once again, he moves back into that corner to get ready for his dismount. So far, he's right on target. Oklahoma is very comfortable again on floor exercise. Final pass, round off pick handspring, layout double twist to a perfect landing.
Fine performance by Jared Hanks. Peter, tell me about the strength it takes in this event.
Well, this is basically like the push-up position, but your feet just happen to not be on the ground. It's called a plange. From there, he presses all the way up to a handstand. That's not tumbling power like you'd normally see on the floor, but a lot of strength in the shoulders.
Jared Hanks with a 9.775, and the Oklahoma Sooners on a roll. They come back to take the lead over Penn State. UCLA still running third, and we'll check in with Leslie Visser when we come back. Welcome back to the Rec Hall on the campus of Penn State University. Greg Gumbel along with Peter Vidmar. After three rotations, Oklahoma is in the lead, followed by Penn State. And Peter, perhaps the biggest surprise is that UCLA is running third. What gives here?
I have to be honest. I expected them to be very tough from the beginning because of their experience last year. But now they're copying their experience last year. Had some problems in the first event, couldn't recover. Same thing's happening right now. They got to pick it up.
All right. For more information on UCLA, let's check in with Leslie Visser, who's with Coach Art Sherlock. Leslie?
Coach, you struggled a little on the floor. How much of a blow was Cheney's mistake on the horse, and what do you have to do to get back in it?
Well, we just have to have a great second half. There's still a possibility we can get all the way back, but you know, we did have struggled quite a bit on the floor. We didn't get off to a good start, but we're going to give it our best effort in the second half.
What happened with Cheney?
I think he's just a little bit tired, and you know, just gave out a little bit. He's got some problems with his shoulders, but we're going to fight all the way.
Great, thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
And thank you, Leslie. And we start the second half of the competition now. The last three exercises, the parallel bars, the horizontal bar, and the vault. And here's Oklahoma's Jared Hanks on the bars. Are we going to see this young man in the Olympics, Peter?
Well, there's a chance. You know, just in the last few months, the last half of his senior year here at Oklahoma, he's really come into his own, had some great scores in the all-around, in all of the events, doesn't show a lot of weaknesses. Little pommel horse on the parallel bar, some flares, right up to a handstand. Giant front uprise, that's called a back stutz. This is a very difficult skill called a Healy twirl. Actually, he does two in a row. So far, no mistakes. Aside from optional routines that we're seeing today, gymnasts also have to perform compulsories. That could be a key element to whether or not Jared makes an Olympic team. Good lower back dismount. Oklahoma is just not making any mistakes today.
A lot of support from his teammates. Jarrett Hanks, 9-7-2-5 on the parallel bar. Here's Wayne Cowden of Penn State on the high bar.
And Penn State's really going to have to pick it up to stay with Oklahoma and keep up with them. Wayne had a horrible meet in the preliminaries, but he's come on strong so far in the team finals. One-arm giant into a one-arm flyaway half turn. Very difficult release sequence. Another ganger, a flyaway half turn. Getting ready for his dismount. First, a required dorsal grip. Those are called eagle giants. And he finishes with a half-in, half-out, a full twist and double back. Nice, solid set.
Wayne Cowden, the junior from Henrietta, New York. You mentioned the grip. Let's take a closer look.
Yeah, tremendous grip strength required on any one-arm giant sequence. Setting up for that release skill. Great view of some really incredible grip strength.
Wayne Cowden, a 9.675 for Penn State. And we'll move to the vault. And last year's vault champion, Brad Hayashi of UCLA.
And he won that title as a freshman. He does a great laid out Cuervo vault, a hamstring with a half turn into a back layout. That's as good a vault as I've seen during this entire competition. What a great vault. Look at the tremendous power. He takes his heels, driving them back right into the mat.
Go All-American Brad Hayashi with a 9.875 as UCLA continues to battle back from a poor start. Oklahoma coach Greg Buick looking on now as Jeff Lutz approaches the parallel bars.
Jeff recently made the USA men's national team at the Winter Nationals last December. Aspirations along with Jarrett Hanks of making an Olympic team. There's a front 1.25. That's called a back toss, basically just a backflip from hands to hands. Front 1.75, very nicely done, right into an L. Press to a handstand, getting ready for a dismount to a great routine so far. Perfect landing.
You get the impression it's a contagious feeling for the Oklahoma Sooners. Jeff Lutz, a 9.8 as the Sooners continue to roll. And after four rotations, they have the lead over Penn State, UCLA third. And Leslie Visser is with the Oklahoma coach.
Greg, you have a comfortable lead, and you're headed for an event that you do particularly well on. What do you have to do?
Well, we just have to hit routines. We're having a great meet, probably the best one we've had all year, without question, and we just got to keep hitting routines. We're on the back nine. We call it the back nine, the last three events, you know, and they're the best events for us, so as long as we just keep hitting routines, I think we'll be okay.
Thank you, Coach.
And we'll continue to play the back nine after this from your local station. Welcome back to University Park, Pennsylvania, home to Penn State University. 30,500 students enrolled. And here at Rec Hall, after four rotations, Penn State actually has inched a little closer to Oklahoma. And there's Coach Greg Buick of the Sooners. His squad moves to the high bar, and freshman Rick Swayze is up. The freshman from Denver looking to duplicate the performance of one Peter Vidmar back in 1983. Has this on the high bar technique. He ought to know, he's a former national champion.
If there's one event that has to be considered the real crowd pleaser in gymnastics, it's got to be this big guy up here. The horizontal bar is tailor-made for the gymnast to push the envelope to the outer limits of gymnastics daring. While the very intricate hand changes and the one-arm giant swings are very important changes recently on horizontal bar, the most spectacular, of course, are the big release moves and the super dismounts that we're seeing nowadays. This is the event that could either make or break this team competition.
And as Rick Swayze is set to go to work, are there an awful lot of changes that take place from one year to the next?
Well, you really don't see it from year to year, but if you had to go maybe 4 years at a time and look at the differences, you could see some real big ones. This is a very good event for Oklahoma. They're really on their strongest events now. Swayze does a reverse heck with his legs together, very difficult, right into a giant swing. There's that required dorsal grip, the eagle giants. So far, he's right on track, setting up for his dismount. It's a double layout to a great landing.
Let's talk about setting up for the dismount, Peter.
Well, if you take a look at the horizontal bar, it has a very strong bend to it. As he lets go of the bar, he gets just the right ping that gives him the right lift and rotation to bring his body around to see the floor in that landing.
You mentioned this is a strong event for the Sooners. Rick Swayze, a 9.75 on the high bar. Penn State moves to the vault now. Here's Jamie Downer.
Jamie does a very unique vault. He hits the board, does a front flip onto the horse, and a handspring off, kind of backwards. Does it well.
Appreciative fans. Appreciative dad.
And Greg, about halfway through the season, the Penn State Nittany Lions were getting some low scores on some weaker vaults. About half the team changed to do this vault, and they're getting scores that are helping them right now in the team finals.
Jamie Downer, big favorite on campus at Penn State, a 9.65 on the vault. And Chaney Humphrey of UCLA moves to the parallel bars.
And I'm curious to see what he's going to do. Art Sherlock told me he was going to try a double back flip within the bars. Let's see if he goes for it. And he's going for it. Oh, he fell right through the bars. That's a major mistake. UCLA is just out of it right now.
Coach Art Sherlock, understandably concerned. How easy is it to just forget about this and jump right back up?
Well, he knows he's got a major mistake. Right now, he just wants to get off the parallel bars and go home almost. Has another event with horizontal bar to try to make up for it, but anytime you have a major crash in a team finals, it's really demoralizing. There's a Stutz, a low one. Saw him wincing earlier. He may have hurt that shoulder even more. Here's his press to a handstand. Another Stutz. Boy, just doesn't look very dynamic right now. Ooh, he's fighting that handstand. That shoulder could really be hurting. Double back dismount. Poor performance right now for Chaney Humphrey.
And you'd have to think that pretty much eliminates UCLA from any chance of winning the championship, an 8.6 for Humphrey. Here's Ricky Armstrong, Oklahoma junior, approaching the high bar and trying to nail things down for the Sooners as the Nittany Lions look on.
Ricky's another example of the real depth that Oklahoma has all the way through their lineup. Those are some nice wrong-way stalders, we call them. It's a one-arm giant into a one-arm flyaway with a half turn. Little break in the legs as he caught the bar. So far, he's still very solid. Turn into the eagle grip giants. Setting up for his dismount. And a double layout with a full twist. Very difficult dismount, and he had a fantastic landing.
Peter, you said early on this was a good apparatus for Oklahoma, and they are nailing their routines.
They certainly are. Take a look at that last skill he does where he nails his dismount. This is one of those skills where you just don't really see the ground until it hits you. And it just happened to be in the right spot for Ricky Armstrong.
9.775 for Ricky Armstrong. Penn State wondering if they can keep up with the Sooners. We've completed five rotations. It's Oklahoma ahead. We'll be back. Welcome back to Penn State as we approach the sixth and final rotation. The Oklahoma Sooners in the lead over Penn State and UCLA. And Oklahoma's Jared Hanks about to approach the vault, an apparatus that Coach Greg Buick knows that his squad works well on.
And they do work well on it. And I'll tell you, when you finish a competition to go on vault, it's a very secure event for them. Very nice vault. Big step. Going to cost them just a little bit. But he'll still get a very good score.
The coach likes it. His teammates like it. Let's have another look.
Complicated vault. There's a quarter turn onto the horse, and a one and a quarter turn in a full flip off. Not quite the rotation that would give him a secure landing. See if we catch a different view of this. A lot of flipping, a lot of twisting. It's hard to see the ground when you land facing frontwards, and that's probably why Jared took that step back.
Jared Hanks, a 9.5 on his vault. And Penn State moving to the parallel bars now. And Jamie Downer about to perform for Penn State for the last time. He's a senior. He had this to say about the fans here in University Park.
The crowd is
unbelievable. Penn State crowd is unbeatable. I mean, I've traveled pretty much throughout the U.S. with a gymnastics team, but I've never experienced a crowd like the Penn State crowd. I mean, the whole Penn State atmosphere, the whole team, the people behind the team, the academic staff, they're all so, you know, gung-ho gymnastics, and it's great.
And they're gung-ho over Jamie here as well.
They really are.
This is not a strong apparatus for Penn State.
No, it really isn't. They have no real stars on parallel bars, and that's why it's going to be difficult for them to catch up with Oklahoma right now. Interesting side mount. There's a V press on one bar. Very unique. And there's a giant swing to a front uprise. Swing pirouette. A stutz to a handstand. Nothing real stellar about this performance so far. That was a front uprise swing pirouette. Just kind of filler skill. Not a lot of super tricks here. The difficulty level is not too high for Jamie, but he's not making any mistakes. A layout full twist, good landing once again. Not as difficult as the double tuck that we've seen a lot throughout the day.
And what an emotional moment it must be for Jamie Downer, who completed his gymnastics career here at Penn State. And as we said, he is a proud favorite here on campus. This is a young man we're likely to see in the Olympics.
Very possibly. He was the 1986 junior all-around champion for England. He's on their national team right now. We could see him in Barcelona.
Back to the vault, and here is Oklahoma's Jeff Lutz.
Same vault as Jared Hanks, but in the layout position, a lot harder, and he did it a lot better. A great landing.
Think Greg Buick knows he's closing in on a championship?
Oh, I think they know they just got it in the bag now.
A 9-7-0 for Jeff Lutz. And now UCLA's Chaney Humphrey, who has had a tough day, Peter.
He really has, but let's not forget, he is one of the country's best gymnasts. He was the Olympic Festival all-around champion. Of course, he has aspirations for the Olympics. He'll be back next year. Now he just needs to show everybody what he's made of. He does some very difficult release sequences. There's a reverse heck with his legs together, into another one, into a flyaway half turn, a triple release move. Boy, he's going for broke. Turns into his Eagle Giants. Setting up now for his dismount. So far, no mistakes, a double layout to a perfect landing.
Look of relief on Chaney's face. Outstanding performance after, as we said, a tough day.
It really was a tough day, but he finished on a great, great note.
Take a look at those releases.
This is so difficult to do three consecutive release moves in a row. A reverse heck with legs together. Very tough just by itself. There's another one. And right into a flyaway with a half turn. Right on target.
And a 9.9 for Chaney Humphrey. Now here's Adam Carton. This is a young man, Peter, who left Penn State at one point, went west, thought the grass would be greener at Cal Santa Barbara, and decided that he was wrong.
He said he knew that after 3 weeks at Santa Barbara. He just missed the environment in the gym at Penn State, decided to come back. He said that the team welcomed him with open arms, and he's thrilled to be back at Penn State. And he's making a difference for the team. So far, he's doing a solid routine. There's a back toss, another back toss. Little bobble on the handstand there. Getting ready for his dismount. Double pike, very tough dismount, nice landing.
Nice routine for Adam Carton, but appears to be too little too late for the Nittany Lions. 9-5-5 is Carton's score on the parallel bars. And the last Oklahoma Sooner of the day, Brian Halstead.
The team's got a smile on all their faces. They know it's all over. All he has to do is finish with a great vault, and they've won the national title.
As Brian Halstead came down the runway, a look at the bench. I think they know it. 9-7-5 is Brian Halstead's score, and Oklahoma Sooners wearing the look of champions. The Oklahoma Sooners, national champions. We'll hear from Coach Greg Buick and fill you in on the individual winners in just a moment.
Let's go, let's march down.
Back at Rec Hall here at Penn State University, the site of the 1991 Men's Gymnastics Championships. Congratulations to the Sooners of Oklahoma. Penn State finishing second and UCLA third. Leslie Visser is with the winning coach.
Greg, you said you were confident, you were healthy, and you had no excuses. What won it for you tonight?
Well, we hit 35, 36 routines, you know. Once we got through Palm Horse, we had a lot of confidence going into Palm Horse, and when we hit six routines, we're off and running. I don't think anyone could have caught us after that.
Who was particularly impressive?
Well, Jared Hanks and Jeff Lutz both went 58 in the all-around, set career highs. Jared broke our school record, and we set a school record in for a team, too, so... You know, what can you ask for?
This is your first title, the Sooners' third. What does that mean to you?
Well, obviously, it's great to win a national title. I'm really thankful that the University of Oklahoma has given us this opportunity because, you know, without them, obviously, we couldn't have this great performance. We've had a lot of great teams, and this is undoubtedly the best, and I'm just glad that everything turned out the way we hoped it would.
Well, congratulations. Well done.
Thank you. Appreciate
Thank you, Greg.
Well done indeed. The Oklahoma Sooners winning their first team title since 1978. We said early on Jared Hanks and Jeff Lutz would lead the way. They did. Good overall performance. Let's take this moment to look at the champions of the individual competition that took place here at Penn State. And we'll begin with John Roethlisberger, who took the all-around title.
He really did. Had a great performance. He has a long history of gymnastics in his family. His dad is the coach at Minnesota. His sister is an Olympian. Nice full-end mount on his floor routine. John was also the 1990 USA All-Around Champion. He was our number one gymnast last year. And he's definitely got big hopes for the 1992 Olympic Games.
This young man from Afton, Minnesota, his dad's been coaching the Golden Gophers gymnastics team since 1972.
And the Gophers have had some close calls lately. They lost the team title last year by a tenth of a point. They just missed making it into the team finals this year by one-tenth of a point. But John should really help the team coming into the next couple years. Really couldn't help the team as much as he would have liked this year. He had a serious ankle injury, and he's just coming back into form. Here's a scale, catching his breath, getting ready for his final tumbling pass. Really had a very solid competition throughout the entire weekend. Good full in back out for a dismount. Very difficult.
John Roethlisberger tied also for the title in parallel bars with this young man, UCLA Scott Keswick.
Scott took second in the all-around at the NCAA championship here. But on the parallel bars, he really had a great performance. Very powerful stitz to a handstand. Front uprise, front 1 3/4, right to a straddle cut and an L. This is a very solid routine. This is very indicative of the year that he's been having at UCLA. He's been a very solid performer, kind of the backbone of the team. Back toss, a stutz. Setting up for a very difficult double pike dismount with just a little hop.
Penn State's Adam Carton had an outstanding individual competition, winning the rings and the vault. We'll first look at him on the rings, Peter.
This is an example of the real power that Penn State has as the nation's number one team on the rings. There's a kip to a Maltese cross into another one. Down to an L cross, and he pulls out of it. A hollow back press to a handstand. Once again, these rings move. The only piece of equipment that moves, and it's very difficult to keep them steady. Giant setting up for his dismount. A piked full twisting double back to a perfect landing.
And now to the vault.
And Adam won with a very powerful vault, a quarter on front, 1 1/4 turn off. Good landing. Took the title away from Brad Hayashi, who won it last year. But Brad won the floor exercise with an excellent performance. His first tumbling pass was a double layout with a great landing. Brad's very solid. He's a good performer on floor. Good body style and technique. Nice front tumbling.
A look at a young man we have not seen until now, the horizontal bar champion Luis Lopez from the University of New Mexico. Tremendous story about this young man who had back surgery.
He had a very serious operation, and he's been able to overcome that. He's a great all-around gymnast as well. Had a nice high bar routine, nice stalders, hops, turns. Gets ready for a spectacular dismount. He does a triple backflip. One, two, three, right on the ground.
But the young man who was the highlight of the weekend, particularly here at Penn State, Mark Sohn, and his specialty, the pommel horse.
Yeah, it really is his specialty because this is his fourth title in 4 years. Only one other gymnast has done that on any event, and that was the vaulting champion, Chad Fox, a few years ago. Works across the horse in flair. Talking to him earlier, Mark said that he's only made two mistakes in his entire college career. Just unbelievable on an event like pommel horse. He goes down his history as one of the finest pommel horsemen ever in college gymnastics. Probably the best.
Something special here at Penn State University. Mark Sohn on the pommel horse. And doesn't that reflect his four-year career?
Sure does. There's nothing better than scoring a perfect 10.
But the team championship went to the Oklahoma Sooners. We'll be back. One more look at the newly crowned champions. So 2 days of competition produces Oklahoma as the national champion. And Peter Vidmar, the bottom line is they were a high-scoring team all season long, and they didn't let up come championship time.
No, and the real key in this competition was momentum. UCLA got off to a horrible start on floor exercise, and it just pounds them around when that happens. They couldn't get it going where they needed to. Penn State had a few problems here and there, and they just couldn't overcome that huge momentum that Oklahoma got on pommel horse and carried out throughout the entire competition. You take the last 2 days, plus the individual apparatus finals, we had some great world-class gymnastics.
We did. Enjoyed working with you, Peter. Congratulations to the Oklahoma Sooners, NCAA Men's Gymnastics Champions for 1991. For Peter Vidmar and Leslie Visser, I'm Greg Gumbel. Thank you for joining us. We hope you've enjoyed it. So long from Penn State University. A reminder, it's the season premiere of CBS Sports Sunday next, the IAAF ADT World Marathon Cup from London.
CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Men's Gymnastics Championships has been sponsored by Honda, maker of fine quality automobiles. Test drive a Honda at your local dealer today. Advil, advanced medicine for pain. And by New Havilland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car.
Gymnastics Championships have been a presentation of CBS Sports.